With so few allowed into Queensland as the barrier to keep Delta out is strengthened by order of the Chief Health Officer from Friday, you'll need more than an exemption pass to cross the border.
Must have had at least one dose of vaccine.
Whilst we see that outbreak in New South Wales, until that is well and truly contained, it will be there for the foreseeable future.
More vaccines are being pushed to the cross-border region, and those who are deemed essential to pass back and forth will get priority at vaccination centres.
Most of these people would already have been vaccinated because we've been vaccinating healthcare workers, police, emergency services since February.
While in the city, good numbers have rolled up their sleeves, some with the added bribe of an Ekka Sunday, the take-up rate in other suburbs is lagging behind targets. The state government wants to send more than 100,000 additional doses of Pfizer sourced federally where they're needed most.
What we want to do there is we want to expand the capacity at Logan and also at Caboolture.
With the latest Queensland outbreak contained, the push is part of preparations for the next one.
We are extremely concerned about the possibility of this virus coming into Queensland.
Another 478 cases in New South Wales saw 91 infectious in the community and 7 lives lost.
Clearly the case numbers are putting a lot of stress on our public health contact tracing systems.
Among the recorded deaths, a 15-year-old boy, more vulnerable to the infection than most.
He died from pneumococcal meningitis. He also was a COVID positive case.
60 Minutes notice all those in Darwin, Palmerston and Katherine had before a snap 72-hour lockdown after a man in his 30s tested positive after being in those areas.
An hour is a long time when you're dealing with COVID, as is a day.
Victorians will know that only too well for another fortnight, their lockdown extended and a 9-to-5 curfew implemented.
We see too many cases. We see too many mystery cases. We now have 12 or 13 different chains of transmission. The origins of some are unknown to us. We are at a tipping point.
And the point of peak frustration. Police are investigating this footage of an engagement party. It's believed 69 people attended unmasked.
And clearly this is legal because this is a group therapy session.
It could be a super spreader event. A positive case was among the guests.
It's selfish. They are choices. And they will keep us all locked down for longer than we should be. I'm angry. We're all angry.
Also facing longer restrictions, the national capital, after 19 new cases were recorded in Canberra.
They have worked elsewhere in Australia and overseas, and if we do the right thing, it will work here in Canberra.
As the Sunshine State, encircled by the COVID threat on a double donut day, tries to avoid falling into the hole of another outbreak. Chris Campbell for 10 News First.